Hello, and welcome to another video. If you are new to this channel, my name is Frank Zhu, and I'm a college professor teaching sociology, history, and philosophy. I'm also an award-winning landscape photographer. We all know that we human beings are obsessed with friendships, romantic relationships, dating, love, sex, marriage, and so on and so forth. Romantic relationships seem to be especially fascinating to us, as so many playwrights, novelists, poets, and musicians have written with eloquence and emotion about love that is pursued, won, and lost. Many socio-psychological researchers have showed that the relationships we seek and enjoy with other people are more important than anything else. In this video, I'm going to talk about one very important aspect of human relationships, that is, attraction. More specifically, I'm going to talk about how we human beings get attracted to each other. This is going to be a very big topic, and as I usually don't make long videos, I'll probably divide it into two videos. To introduce this topic to you, let me start with a few questions. Why are we drawn to each other? Why are we so attracted to some people but not others? What determines how our intimate relationships evolve over time? What does it mean to love someone? The need to belong is a fundamental human motive. Every human being feels a very strong need to belong throughout their lifetime. As a matter of fact, if you think about the amount of time that you spend talking to, being together with, flirting with, or worrying about other people, you will be amazed and you will realize that we are all social animals, which simply means people need to be together with other people. We feel joy when we form new social attachments and react with anxiety and grief when those bonds are broken. We care deeply about what others think of us, which is why we spend so much time and money to make ourselves presentable and attractive. The need to belong is so deep that people get very distressed when they are neglected, rejected, or excluded. In fact, some of us are so worried about how we appear to others that we suffer from various symptoms of social anxiety disorder. For example, when you make a presentation and feel weak in the knees, which is a typical symptom of the so-called stage fright, you are experiencing such disorder. The reason is simple. You are so eager to make others like or love you, and you are not sure if you can successfully do so. People who are in a relationship are different from people who are not. According to research, those people who have close social ties, such as lovers, friends, family members, and co-workers, have a higher self-esteem and greater satisfaction with life compared to those who live more isolated lives. They are also physically healthier and less likely to die a premature death. The human fundamental motive to belong starts with the so-called need for affiliation, which is a socio-psychological term that refers to a desire to establish a social contact with other people. There are various reasons why we long for the company of others. For example, we want to celebrate a holiday with family members rather than alone. When we hear good news, we want to share it with our friends. Affiliating can satisfy us for other reasons as well. One of them is stress. You may have noticed how your neighbors, who have never stopped to say hello to you, come together in snowstorms, hurricanes, power failures, and other major crises. Researchers have found that an external threat can trigger fear and motivate us to affiliate, particularly with others who face a similar threat. Stress is not the only state of mind that inspires people to affiliate. Being alone and feeling lonely will motivate people of all ages to connect with other people. As I said, affiliation is a necessary first step in the formation of a social relationship. But each of us is more drawn to some people than to others. If you have ever had a crush on someone, felt the tingly excitement of a first encounter, lusted after a celebrity, or enjoyed the first moments of a new relationship, then you know the meaning of the term attraction. When you meet someone for the first time, what qualities do you look for? Does a familiarity breed fondness or contempt? Do birds of a feather flock together, or do opposites attract? Is beauty the object of your desire, or do you believe that outward appearances are deceiving? And what is it about a situation or the circumstances of an initial meeting that draws you in for more? Many researches have been done in this aspect. According to one classic perspective, people are attracted to those with whom they can have a relationship that is rewarding. The rewards may be direct, as when people provide us with attention, support, money, status, information, and other valuable resources. Or the rewards may be indirect, as when it feels good to be with someone who is beautiful, smart, or funny, or who happens to be in our presence when times are good. Another more recent research, which was based on the so-called evolutionary approach, and which has been quite influential recently, showed that human beings all over the world exhibit patterns of attraction and mate selection that favor the conception, birth, and survival of their offspring. In other words, every one of us tends to form relationships with those we consider as good for us in terms of biological needs. Now, let me focus on some major factors which affect how we get attracted to each other and form a relationship, based on the lots of sociological and psychological researches. The first factor is what we call the proximity effect. The single best predictor of whether two people will get together is physical proximity or nearness. In general, some of our most important social interactions occur among those people who find themselves living or working in the same place at the same time. The second factor is the so-called the mere exposure effect. The more often people see something or someone new, the more they will like it. We tend to prefer things or people we are more familiar with. For example, if you walk by someone every day, you will feel that you know and trust them, even though you don't know anything about them. This is especially true with the social interactions. You might like people more if you spend a lot of time around them, such as co-workers or potential romantic partners. The third factor, which is perhaps the most important factor affecting attraction, is physical attractiveness. As children, we were often told that beauty is only skin deep and that we should not judge a book by its cover. Yet, as adults, we often find ourselves reacting more favorably to those who are physically attractive than to those who are not. Over the years, socio-psychological studies have shown that in the affairs of our social and economical world, from childhood through adulthood, physical beauty always plays an essential role in all kinds of relationships. Well, I think I have to stop here for this video today, because the topic of beauty is such an important and a big topic, it deserves a separate video. So, in my next video, I will focus on the topic of beauty and discuss how beauty, or more accurately, our perceived beauty, plays a role in human attraction and the formation of close relationships. Please subscribe to my channel if you don't want to miss it. Thank you for watching this video, and I will see you in the next one.